Welcome to our new home! And if you are new to my channel, oh welcome. If you would like to be part of my crew, please subscribe. And also if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And let's head on into the full house tour.
So the day has come that we're actually finally moving in some stuff into our house. We're setting up a bed tonight. We get to sleep in our house for the very first time. I have not seen the kitchen yet. The counters are in and the new sink, faucet, all of these things. And I just like haven't seen it yet. So I'm like super excited, but can we just take a moment? Can we just take a moment? The whole car is full with stuff.
So I know this mat is kind of wet, but it is from HomeSense. This is from Michaels, just like a plastic white pumpkin so it doesn't rot. And then this beautiful wreath is also from HomeSense. Absolutely love the colors.
Well, we were confused because there was a hook set down on the door, and then I realized it was because they had to hang the wreath somehow with a string over top, but then it kind of looks stupid, so I put this little bow and this little be thankful sign. We have a little mudroom, which I think I'm going to put like a big mirror right there so that you have like a final look before you go out and kind of can see like jacket, shoes, if that all works with the outfit together. The carpet is from HomeSense. The little bench, I just basically put there because when like parents come over and they're kind of like older and then you just sit down and put on shoes, you're welcome. The bench is from Yisk, and the pillow and all the decor is also from HomeSense, so I just made a little fall corner. And then we just have our closet with all of our jackets. It feels so good to have space for things like that, and it doesn't need to be right beside your juicer in the kitchen. This is Matt's man cave. It's not finished, it just has a couch, a wall color, and a carpet from IKEA. But he has a TV, we just gotta put it up and make this more homey. And the door is missing. What happened to this door?
It's in the garage.
Yeah. The door needs to be put back in because it's kind of cold in here. It needs a heater, I feel like, too. Let's go upstairs.
So we changed out this entire carpet, which was old and just really gross. Then we have a accent wall on this side of the living room that goes all the way down into our hallway at the front, which is a light mineral blue, which goes really well with the color carpet that we chose. And then we decided to keep this trim white to kind of have a separation. And then here we need a transition strip, like nosing from the carpet to the actual flooring, which is vinyl, by the way. I'm pretty sure it's 3 millimeters, and the color is kind of a pale gray white. Then we're still missing a piece of baseboard right here because we had to wait until our fireplace was installed, which is my most favorite part of the living room. So this is what it looks like when you first come up here. We did a click-in type of flooring, then this beautiful carpet that definitely goes with like our color scheme of like the mineral blue, and our dark midnight blue couch is from Home Depot, which I was so surprised that they had this beautiful of a carpet. Then this table that I got in so many questions about is from HomeSense. These were sent by my mom. These are from Germany, just like rose gold, everything. This little thing is also from HomeSense. Then this couch is like my favorite couch I've ever had. It's in this beautiful velvet, midnight blue, dark blue. And we found this at the Urban Barn outlet. Then I got these big pink pillows, also at Urban Barn, IKEA. This one came with it. This one is from, or like the pillowcase itself is from Walmart, which goes with the other pink pillows. And then HomeSense, Urban Barn. And then this is kind of like my little bohemian California corner. Because everywhere you went, they had these beautiful drapes on the walls and just like everywhere, and I loved it. So I found this one at Winners. This is from Walmart to kind of just complete the jungle and the pink that goes with the pillows. Then these two plants are actually both from Walmart for like $8 or $10, which is nothing. And also the pots are from Walmart, from IKEA. And then this pretty little side table, I want it. I definitely wanted a side table. There was a bunch of different options, but I really liked the design on the top. And then the bottom is, again, kind of this like, almost like more rocking themed, metal punched out hole detail. So yeah, this is kind of like my favorite corner of the whole living room. And then quickly, I had to take in our cushions from the outside because it's kept raining, and also this plant had seen better days. It died because it was way too hot. But I got this cute little mat for outdoors, and then this is our furniture set, which is, again, this like light gray color. And we got that whole set for like $400 at Jysk, which was such a good deal. Barbecue is covered up, but it's a Napoleon barbecue. Matt can probably tell you more about that because I don't know anything about it. And then we slowly started to like hang things on the wall. So we hung our silver mirror that goes with this kind of like side table and kind of the dining room table, which has silver detailing like legs and then glass mostly detail. So it's kind of like mirrored glass silver in this corner or this area of the living room. Then got this little shelving thing at IKEA where you can just kind of like lean things against the wall. Really like that. I feel like there is still a lot of space, so I feel like it needs to be filled with something else on the wall. Then this is fairly old, but again found at HomeSense. This cool leaf, because it kind of goes with the rest, is from IKEA, so they have that right now if you like that. One of our engagement photos, whiskey, because that's us. And yes, we do listen to, we have a record player. This lamp is also from Home Depot. We got that as well as the lamps for the kitchen. So it's just like a round, again, silver, so it goes with everything else. And then the chairs and this table is from a store in Coquitlam Center. I have no idea what it's called, but I will find out and link that. But it's kind of like a little bit more higher end decor. And this was gifted to us by my opa. So this is something that's gonna come with us everywhere we go. And then this little bookshelf literally just fit on that wall. I don't even know how that was possible, but it's from IKEA. I kind of like, again, it's like this white kind of wash wooden look, and just have like a couple of things in here, just kind of like decor, photos, and then just like two little plants on the top. Then on the other side, we got this little vanity thing at IKEA as well, because we just have a lot of like tablecloths and like decor, and I wanted everything like nicely put away, but then you can pull everything out to like decorate the table, which is right here. So it just makes sense to have that in the living room. This is actually a TV stand, so it has a hole at the back, so technically you could put like a TV like holder on the back and then put all your electronics and stuff in it. So yeah, so like all of like tablecloths, and then I keep all of like gift bags and boxes and things that you can reuse in there. Hashtag hoarding. But again, it's kind of a lighter wooden detail with white. These three little rose gold candle jars are from Germany. This beautiful rose gold pumpkin I got from HomeSense. This was a gift from my family when we got engaged. It's like a really special, I always like forgot what the brand is, but you gift that when people get married, and it's like supposed to keep the love in your house. And our little Himalayan salt lamp, this beautiful little guy, I think is also from Walmart, as well as the pot. Love this one. And we just got our little light up M&J. That is from Michael's way back. And then got our little diffuser from Sage. Again, silver, so it goes with everything else. And then I keep postcards from people. I can't throw them away. And then we have a drawer with photos from our engagement party and just people that we love in general. And it's just like nice to look at and just be happy. How cute, our first Christmas tree. Ooh, that by the way is so exciting because we actually get to put a real life Christmas tree in here and I don't know where I'm gonna put it yet, but. The curtains are also from Jysk and I went with gray to go with the flooring. The main beautiful piece of this living room, which is this built-in fireplace. I'm gonna link their Instagram handle and like information in the info box. So we just like decided that this was like our feature wall and that we wanted something just like an eye catcher. And it had an older fireplace and Matt was like immediately, "Ooh, I don't want it." I didn't even mind it, but like he's like, "No, like it's not good enough, like I want to tear it out." So we decided that we wanted to go with like an electric fireplace. And I could just like not envision what it would have looked like if we just would have had this piece and just like stuck it on the wall. So he kind of like took over like research and everything for it and then came up with this idea and then told me about it. I was like, "Oh my god, yes." So we got this beautiful white marbled stone slab, gotten the fireplace separately. So there is a built wooden frame underneath it. And then we set the fireplace inside and then they put the stone slabs on the front and then obviously closed it. But it's so beautiful. And then this fireplace came with like a whole bunch of different like rocks and like things. So I just kind of put like a little bit of like sea glass and different kind of natural looking rocks in there. But we have like another box like this, just like full with decor. So we could switch it up anytime we want to because you just take out the glass and then switch it out. And it's now hooked up to a furnace as well. So there is heat coming out, but it's not a gas fireplace. It's electric. So it just like looks really pretty because it kind of shines through the bottom and through the bottom and then in the glass, and it's just, yeah, it looks so good. And then what we're going to do in this corner is we're gonna have like probably on the bottom that's the last piece really that needs to be done, a bottom like shelving unit where we can put all like the cables and all that kind of stuff in it so it doesn't look like this. And then we might put like some more shelving in there, but we still have to like find the right kind of like measurement like pieces because built-in is way more expensive and we don't really want to spend that kind of money. And then we got a new TV, which is huge. That's why that's why I wanted this as well, because I feel like just like looking at this big piece of like dark, like black hole, just to make it look better. It'll look much better once the cables kind of like can disappear in that shelving over there. So let's head into our kitchen. I'm sorry if you can hear the dishwasher running and also we're missing a piece. I'm not sure what happened to it, but there's stuff hanging out of our dishwasher. In the kitchen, we basically redid everything. Before, it was like a dark brown cupboard front and no backsplash. The counters were kind of like an old yellowish color. And then we had tiles in here that Matt scraped out of here and he was very happy about me telling him to do it. The big thing in the kitchen is that we didn't have this counter, this island, because before it was just like an empty space. So basically the kitchen was just like an L shape going just like around and then it had this big empty space. But because I was feeling like, why would we put a table right there if we have our dining room table literally right here? So it just like made no sense to me to like leave this whole space like open. So had a contractor come in and we like measured how big we wanted the kitchen island to be. We have a slide overhang so that all of our chairs, which are by the way from Jysk, much more inexpensive than like the brick or somewhere else. And so that when you're sitting, that your knees go under it. But we picked this beautiful white marbled looking countertop. It is not marble because you actually can't use marble. in the kitchen because it's like very soft material. So if you spill anything, it just like sinks right, it sinks right into the counter, which is like impractical in a kitchen because you're gonna spill so many things. This is a quartz countertop. And we're very happy with the outcome because before we were looking at little slabs, like little like samples, which were literally the size of this, and all you could see was like this. So we then decided to go on the actual website and look at the full slab, and I am so happy that we did because we would have had a completely different pattern and it would have not looked the way it does right now. Then we redid all the cupboard fronts to a high gloss white soft closure with these little with these kind of like small handles everywhere. So we redid all of the cupboards at the front. So we just redid the whole cupboard fronts. We didn't replace the entire cupboard because that would have been way more expensive, but we got lucky because the inside was already white, so we didn't have to change or like paint the inside. And yeah, so these are all high gloss. I'm pretty sure made in Italy. And yeah, I love that it's soft closing. We have a wine rack built into our island, and I'm very happy that it's empty right now because 1 month of birthday celebrations, I need a detox, and we put in this bar fridge, which unfortunately, even though this is the second one we had to replace it, it's still kind of like, as you can see, it's like not flush. Thanks Best Buy. And this thing was so heavy to carry up here, like that was horrible. But in general, like moving heavy furniture into this house was the death of my back. So we have the same white high gloss front on the island, and then all of our drawers are also soft closure. However, all the drawers are brand new, so they built these new. So satisfying. Then in this corner we had like a Lazy Susan, which we took out and then had shelving put in because it's just simply so impractical. We decided to go with a more like industrial big sink because I wanted space so that you can wash big pots and pans with like no problem. And then we got this faucet that's also kind of like industrial looking, but it's just like really easy to handle and then has a magnetic attachment. I made a little coffee corner for us. Love coffee. Love coffee. With our Keurig, I'm pretty sure it's from Canadian Tire. And this is our actual like cappuccino espresso machine, which has a foamer. And yeah, I haven't used it yet because I'm too lazy and I should use it. We had to buy a new microwave because the old one was broken and we were kindly not told that. Thanks. Also, we have to fix the ice machine in the fridge for whatever reason, also not working. I don't know. No idea. I'm not good at that kind of stuff. That's Matt's job. But we kept all the old appliances. So the fridge, the stove, and the dishwasher are all old because we just like felt like, because this kitchen is just so white that it needed like a darker appliance. And I think we're gonna replace this hood vent though because we don't really like how you can see inside. We changed in here is lighting. So Matt and Andy installed all these like pot lights in like the L shape that the counter is running. Then we also installed these lights to hang right over top of the island. These lamps, I think all of our lamps, I don't know where the pot lights are from, but these lamps and all the other lamps in our house are all from Home Depot, which is amazing. So yeah, we went with like a more like modern look, and trust me, hanging these the same height, that was a struggle. And then the other big thing in here is the backsplash because there was none before. So we went with a beveled subway tile. Beveled meaning it, when you look at it, it actually has like a 3D edge. So it's not just like flush against the wall, so it gives a little bit more dimension. And yeah, we did that all the way around into that corner as well. And I absolutely love the look of it. It's just like so clean and kind of like almost like farmhouse style, which is like definitely what I like. The same people that did the backsplash also did our fireplace. And yeah, I'm obsessed. Absolutely amazing work. Yeah, totally, totally love it. But I feel like this kitchen still needs like some sort of like art right there. But I think I'm going to go with like something that I can hang that is season related. So like for Christmas, there will be something different. Fall, like spring, everything, if that makes sense. And then I don't know if I want to hang more on this wall or if I want to just keep it clean. I might put like a, I don't know, like a pretty like mirror, like an elongated mirror, just like open up the room even more. I don't know if it's even necessary to put anything on this wall, really. Okay, let's head on upstairs. So again, the same kind of gray, light gray carpet that we redid. There was like old carpet all on here and was just, it did not look very good. We hung a few pieces of art just in here that are kind of the same type of like gold details. We're gonna have our actual wedding photo in there and our engagement photo. And I'm gonna put a few like candle, like jars, different sizes in like glass jars with, again, either some gold candles or like some kind of gold decor to go with these two things. This carpet is, by the way, so comfy. This little carpet I got at Walmart, which is, I love this type of like Aztec, kind of like bohemian look. We got a laundry closet, which is so exciting, but really unexciting really to show you, but to just have all the stuff where it belongs and it's not like everywhere. Because this is our actual laundry right here, which is much bigger than the ones that we had before and newer, and just, it's so nice to have proper clean laundry and it actually comes out clean. So then right when you come up here, this is where you go to the master bedroom. This is the bathroom for like our guests. So we have like a big bathtub, and then we're gonna redo this bathroom at some point just because I don't like the color of this, or the flooring, or the counter, or those broken lights, so don't judge. I want it, again, kind of like white and clean and have some kind of like dark blue accents, I think, just like with like towels and decor, but everything else is gonna be, it's just going to be white, 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 white. And this is the second bedroom that I use for our guests when they sleep over, so we have a nice day bed that we got at IKEA. It was really inexpensive, really. All the drawers you can store your bedding in, and then you just pull out the drawer on the bottom and fold over the mattress for somebody to sleep on, and then when we're not using it, it's just kind of like a couch. And this is, by the way, my favorite wall of the whole house. Dusty rose, as you can tell. Love that color. This is where I film most of my YouTube videos, just because I have the window right here with good lighting. So this is where I do like my makeup tutorials and other like sit down videos. This, I'm just gonna literally like walk you through where I got all the stuff that I got. So this is all IKEA, 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 IKEA. I like having this rack here and just put hangers on it. If there's people staying over, they can hang all their clothes so that they have a spot where to put stuff, because this closet, I'm not gonna open this because maybe just like the top. So basically in this closet we have all of our like dressy clothes for like weddings and whatnot, and then just like travel bags, more laundry, like linens and sheets, and then we got our Christmas decor and more like winter clothes that we don't need on the regular. But this is just kind of like an office space where I can like sit and edit, film, do like stuff that I'm not doing downstairs maybe. We got these kind of like fake wood looking blinds at Walmart as well. And this is, by the way, the view. So like you look into the inside of all the townhouses. So like our car garage is like down there and you can see our patio. But I do want to kind of show you like a few pieces of like decor. I love this like gold leaf. I found this at Save On Foods in like their like home decor section, which is so random. That mirror is from Winners. Then this cozy blanket is from Chapters. This, a pretty dusty rose blanket, is from Jysk. And then pillowcases in this like turquoise color are from IKEA as well. Now let's go into the master bedroom. So just a quick little peek into this bathroom. So same thing, I want to redo this. I just don't like the color, like it's too dark. And yeah, I feel like the flooring needs updating, and I just like this counter I'm not really happy about, or the sink. We have a big, nice shower, but I also kind of want to redo that because, like, if you look at, like, the grout, it's so, like, dark. Like, even when you clean it, it's, like, it's just, it doesn't look clean. This is the master bedroom. On this side, Matt's closet, and then that side is my closet because, obviously, I need more space. I need lots of space. And I'm actually so happy with this closet because I have so much space for everything. Everything has its spot. I have all my gym clothes in this like IKEA rack that I put on its side. And then obviously stuff is color coordinated.
Actually so stoked that we fit a king size bed in here, and this like gray bed frame with this huge headboard, like it's like the height of me basically. I feel like it's just like so much more luxurious to have a headboard where you can kind of like lean against one when you like first like wake up in the morning. You can like sit there, have a coffee. The sheets, this kind of like quilted, is this even how you say that? I don't know. Is from Amazon. I will link that in the info box because people have been asking me about this so much. It comes with these pillowcases as well, and it's just the softest material. I also got just like our underneath white sheets and like pillowcases also from Amazon. I'm gonna link all of those things. This pillow is actually a Christmas pillow. It has a saying on the back, but it's from Winners. This pillow is from Walmart. So then on either side we have two little bedside tables from IKEA and the same lamps that I found at Winners, which I love. They're kind of like, I just think they're so pretty with like the silver and the glass and just plain white because I like everything white. The only thing that we're missing are blinds, and I think I'm gonna go with the same ones that I have in the other bedroom because they're nice and plain and exactly the look that I'm going for. Yeah, this is the kind of like little magic corner of the mirror right in front of the window, and just ignore the camera equipment. These two carpets, one is from IKEA and the pink one I also got from Jysk. Laundry, just ignore that also. This dresser is also from IKEA. I really love this dresser, and Matt is taking up most of the space because his closet is small. On here I just have two photos. One is from Matt proposing, and this is my Oma and my Opa on their wedding day, which is just the cutest thing I've ever seen. I think I'm going to put some art on this wall. I think I'm gonna do a black and white kind of like gallery, either like three big picture frames that are all the same size, or two, I don't know yet, but I feel like this wall definitely needs something.
Bye!